Okay, so today we have New York Dolls and Personality Crisis. So the New York Dolls were requested about, a week ago or something. But I have to say, I've heard of the New York Dolls. I've never listened to them. So yeah, obviously, a true reaction. So let's get into this. I've heard actually, there's a Sex Pistols song, New York, which kind of refers to the New York Dolls. So, not in a nice way. So anyway, we'll get into this, talk about it after, and yeah, let's go. All right, New York Dolls and Personality Crisis. So, his voice. I have to start off with just saying, who's the man singing here? Excuse me. So on, I guess David Johansen, I want to say on vocals. This is from the album, their debut album. There's no personnel just for the song, but I just have to say David on vocals here. I mean, it sounds like he's ripping his vocal cords out of his throat. It's just he's just going all out, and there was kind of like a. I feel like it kind of sounded like the Stones, or almost like he sounded like Jim Morrison, like kind of a Jim Morrison, Mick Jagger, kind of a thing. That's what I felt going on, especially with his, again, I just love The Doors so much and Jim Morrison, but just how Jim Morrison would have that feral scream. That's what I kind of liken David here to. And I mean, it's just like, you know, it's just, he's just going crazy. And like, I can imagine just watching him in the studio or something like that, doing this vocal performance for the song, and just imagining him just going nuts. And yeah, I'm just like, his voice, like immediately when he came in, I was just like, Jesus, it's just, he's going nuts. Anyway, also just to talk about more about the personnel here, on bass guitar, Arthur Kane, who goes by, apparently goes by Killer, so Killer Kane, there's a name for you. Jerry Nolan on drums, Sylvain, I guess that's his name, or Sylvain, whatever, on piano, rhythm guitar, and vocals, and Johnny Thunders, like the last name, on lead guitar and vocals. And I have to say, on piano, Sylvain here, I mean, he just kept tingling those keys. Again, it gave me another kind of a feel of like the Doors. I hate to, you know, compare them to a band. I know some people hate that, but I mean, you know, with the Doors having one of the best keyboardists in Ray Manzarek, again, I just love the piano. I always like how, you know, especially for, I guess it was this, I was gonna say a punk song. I don't know if you would consider this punk. It was more kind of, I guess, you know, glitter, glam rock, I guess, in a way. But yeah, it's just like, the piano, I just really loved, what he was doing there. And, it just really added, especially, you know, it added to David's, you know, insane vocals, and, just have that, you know, the whatever, just the, him going nuts on piano with, Sylvain there. And yeah, I didn't expect this. Yeah, again, just never hearing the band, and only hearing about them in the song New York by the Sex Pistols, which again, I just wanted to talk about that because I did open this up. Just again, I know this is not about the Sex Pistols, but with New York, it says, you know, the song's like a rant about bands from New York in general, but especially the New York Dolls, who Malcolm McLaren briefly managed prior to the Pistols. And again, Malcolm McLaren, I mean, if you've read anything about him or whatever, I mean, I personally don't like him. Well, he's dead now, but he died in 2010, but I mean, he didn't seem like a nice guy, especially, I think Eddie Vedder said something about him at the 2002 Rock and Roll Hall of Fame or something like that, and I think he put it best, but I can't remember what he said now. But yeah, and I mean, going on here, you know, I love the song New York, again, I love the Pistols, but again, I was just, you know, I never listened to the New York Dolls because I just thought, like, you know, oh, the Sex Pistols said this about them, so I'm not going to listen. But I mean, that was like in high school, and I mean, I kind of forgot about the New York Dolls since then, and I mean, yeah, if this song, if this is like anything else that they've done, I mean, my goodness, I've been missing out. Again, I love his voice so much. That's really what stood out to me, and I keep saying it, but that's what's true. And anyway, I guess just to talk about the song here on the About on Genius, like I usually do, just to see what, you know, the song's all about. So it says, Personality Crisis is the lead track from the New York Dolls' incredibly influential debut album, New York Dolls. And also, I have to say, this came out, when did this come out, actually? I just want to see, you know, for a reference here, 1973. Yeah, so even earlier than I thought it was. So again, it's just, it kind of, you can hear, you know, influences into, like, especially into the 80s, I thought. And especially you could hear what they were influenced by, I guess, in 73, like I said, like, by, you know, 60s rock. But you can hear, like, some Motley Crue, or like maybe even some Aerosmith. I mean, Aerosmith was kind of around in 73 as well, I guess. But yeah, it's just, I don't know, you could hear their influence. I could really hear the influence that they would have, and where they got their influence from, I think, which I don't know. I just really like, hearing all that. Anyway, going on here, written by lead singer David, again, Johansson, I want to say, and guitarist Johnny Thunders, the song discusses the fine line between saneness and insanity, drug use and heartbreak. And again, that really kind of makes sense with, you know, saneness and insanity just by his vocals. There are even speculations that this song is in fact about someone who was suffering from, I want to say, Frigoli delusion, or the delusion of doubles, a rare disorder in which a person holds a delusional belief that different people are in fact a single person who changes appearance or is in disguise. So I guess a doppelganger, maybe something like that. Anyway, it says, music journalist Tony Fletcher called it an instant glitter rock anthem, while writer and historian David Sedmeri, I want to say, called it an anthemic and dynamic proto-punk song. So there's punk there, I guess. Yeah, you would, I guess, classify this as punk, I guess. It said in Rolling Stone magazine, Tony Glover wrote that Personality Crisis serves as a jumping companion piece to classics such as The Doors, 20th Century Fox, and Cool Comma Collected by the Rolling Stones. So there it is. I didn't even see, again, So it mentions The Doors and the Rolling Stones here. I swear to God, I did not see this about, I'm not, you know, I don't want to be one of those reactors who, you know, fakes things, whatever. I did not see that. So yeah, it's cool to know that, you know, this kind of, this is a jumping piece from the Doors and the Rolling Stones, because I really did hear The Doors and the Rolling Stones in the song. Anyway, that's nuts. Anyway, I'm glad I got something right here. It says it was ranked in both the 2004 and 2010 list by Rolling Stone in the greatest songs of all time. And again, just how influential it seems to be. It had to be there, I would think. I really like that they compared them to the Rolling Stones, I guess, and the Doors. I'm thinking about that now. It said, also, I just want to say the engineer for the New York Dolls, he said that this was his favorite song on the album. And again, I think this is their most known song, which, I mean, you know, kind of, you know, define the band, I guess. And it's just, I can't get over his vocals. I mean, I'm going to have to hear something by them again at some point, either through this channel or just on my own. But I feel a little sad that the Sex Pistols kind of kept me from listening to this band, because I remember back in high school, again, just listening to punk. I didn't listen to the New York Dolls, and I just thought, listening to New York by the Pistols, I was just like, oh, what, I don't need to listen to the Dolls then, if they're all just like that, because again, I was kind of enamored with the Pistols, I guess, and I kind of didn't really get back into punk since high school. But anyway, here we are now. I finally listened to them, and that voice and that piano, I mean, that's what really stuck out to me, and I just loved it all. And again, the names here, Johnny Thunders, Killer Kane, Sylvan, I guess, and David Johansson. I just like it all. Anyway, I guess that's it. So thanks for the request. Really enjoy the song, really enjoy the message, and I'm really, you know, again, I love the Doors and all of the Stones, so I'm glad that, you know, there's some, you know, hints of them into this. That's really cool. Anyway, so thanks for watching again. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting. Really appreciate all the support. And if you want to suggest anything else, you can, leave a comment, all this stuff, and some, whatever you want to say. Anyway, thanks again for watching. I will talk to you guys again soon.